concert as part of the European Music Gathering Festival. This is a festival organised by the European Union Youth Orchestra, where 31 socially distant live concerts and broadcasts are taking place across Europe. Tonight's is the Irish performance, and it's coming to you from the Museum of Literature Ireland here in Dublin. The musicians that are performing to you this evening are all alumni of the European Union Youth Orchestra, and we are delighted to meet here in Dublin to perform for you. I would like to acknowledge what a challenging year it has been for the arts, and we are so happy that, despite the challenges that face us, the European Union Youth Orchestra have taken the initiative to organise such an inclusive and exciting festival. We, for one, have really enjoyed rehearsing in Dublin this week, and appreciate the opportunity to perform for a live audience once again, albeit a smaller and socially distant one. Our concert begun with Benjamin Britten's Fanfare for St. Edmundsbury, which is a fanfare scored for three natural trumpets and was composed in 1959. As you will have noticed, the trumpets were spread throughout the room, and the last fanfare is a combination of all three melodies which were independently played beforehand. Our next piece is the Fantasy for Horn Quintet in A minor by Charles Stanford. We are very happy to be playing this piece by an Irish composer that has only recently been rediscovered. He himself is an alumnus of the Royal Irish Academy of Music, where we enjoyed rehearsing his piece this week. Following that, the Brass Quintet will perform Domu for Brass Quintet by Natasha Kalberg, and we would like to extend a warm welcome to Natasha, who is actually with us this evening. Natasha is an Australian-Irish composer currently based in Dublin, and the piece was originally premiered in May 2012 as part of the Irish Composers Collective in the National Concert Hall in Dublin. Following that, we'll perform three pieces for string quartet by Igor Stravinsky. These three pieces are short and exciting and have been described as a complete revolt not only against the string quartet as traditionally conceived, but against the very nature of the stringed instrument themselves. Stravinsky himself was very interested, in fact, in Irish history and came to Dublin in 1963 to conduct the Radio Éireann Symphony Orchestra in a concert of his music. Next on the programme is Michael Kamen's Brass Quintet, mostly known for his arranging, songwriting and film scores such as Die Hard and Lethal Weapon. His Brass Quintet was written in 2002 and is a short, reflective essay emphasising warmth and lyricism. And to conclude tonight's concert, we will perform the Quintet for Oboe and Strings by Arnold Bax. Bax was an English composer who had a strong affinity with Ireland throughout his life and is in fact buried in Cork, which is in the south of Ireland. His well-documented love of Ireland began with his discoveries of the poetry of William Butler Yeats. And his Oboe Quintet is highly lyrical and rhapsodic, and in fact the last movement opens with an Irish jig, which apparently the English composer enjoyed from time to time. So we really hope you enjoyed tonight's performance, coming to you from the Museum of Literature Ireland in Dublin as part of the European Music Gallery Festival. We're very excited to play. Thank you.
Thank you.